All right, Jack. So obviously a pretty big win tonight. How are you guys feeling after big 57-0 win, 5-point bonus point? Everything that you guys kind of needed to go right today seemed to go right.
Yeah, you're right. We absolutely needed all five of those points, and the boys showed up, worked hard, and came away with them. Mostly just proud of our defensive effort today. That's been a goal of ours for a couple weeks, so to leave them with zero feels really good.
So obviously the clean sheet, as you mentioned, it's like, what do you think made the defense kind of click so well? There's a few seemed highlight reel hits out there, but also like no real gaps at all at any point during the game.
Yeah, a couple boys had big shots. Honestly, what makes a difference is putting in the work on Tuesday, like a really tough session. All the boys come focused and primed, so yeah. You see it today, but like the work is earlier in the week, and that's what does it.
Yeah, for sure. And for yourself there, I guess Lonnie Faleva has had quite the try-scoring streak, kind of encroaching in on your territory as the team try-scoring lead there. So how important was it to you to get those two tries late in the game? You're hearing some footsteps on the team leaderboard here.
Yeah. Love to get a couple tries, but like those are mall tries. Those are the forwards all working hard. I'm just the lucky guy at the back to dot it down. So yeah. Like those are forwards tries. Those are me.
What's been making the mall so successful for you guys so far this year?
I kind of already mentioned it, but like working really hard early in the week and like going at each other in practice to make each other better because we're buddies, but like also having a real go at each other. So little skills, like getting into the shape first, it makes all the difference.
And any thoughts on that Austin Matthews jersey that's sitting on the bench here? You guys hoping for a little bit of luck and stuff to rub off?
Yeah, hopefully. I wonder what the score is. Probably third period now, I don't know.
It's a 2-1 Tampa in the second intermission.
Okay, plenty of time. I back time. Matthews and the boys. We're going to get it.
All right, hopeful for two big Toronto victories tonight.
Yeah, let's go Toronto.
Perfect. Thanks for the time.
Thanks, guys. Thanks.
James, so obviously a massive win for you guys tonight. Just kind of walk us through what sort of, I guess, went right for you guys in this game. It seemed like pretty much everything did, especially with the clean sheet on the scoreboard at the end of the game.
Yeah, 100%. Like, that clean sheet was the biggest thing. When we went into halftime, that was our number one goal, just to keep them off the scoreboard. We managed to do that, so we're pretty happy with that. I mean, obviously, we had a tough go against New York, so this week was all about responding and just sending a message kind of thing. And we're pretty happy with that.
Yeah, now what specifically about like the way you guys played defense today? It seemed like there was absolutely no gaps at all, but like what just seemed like it worked out really well for you guys on that side of the ball today?
Yeah, all week we basically just worked on speed, vision, and our connection. So basically just trusting the man inside, outside of you, just getting off the line and doing your role and responsibility. So basically the calmer we are, the better we are in defense.
And you got your big first career professional MLR try tonight.
Yeah, just, it didn't get called back this time.
Yeah, it didn't get called back this time, exactly. It should be the second, but it is what it is, I guess. But just kind of walk us through that play and how that that moment felt to you, get that try in front of the home fans tonight.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, it goes to my name on the score sheet, but it was a forward try. Absolutely, we just got the forward momentum going, and Jacko just told me to hold on to it, so I just kind of held on to it and felt right.
And I gotta ask, you're from Calgary. I heard you're a big Flames fan. How do you feel about that Matthews jersey on the bench?
Well, you gotta support the hometown team here. You know, I mean, I'm obviously a Flames fan, but I'd love to see the Leafs go through. Do you score an hour?
I do. It's 2-1 Tampa at second intermission.
Make any chance in the hour. I mean, obviously Matthews is a beauty from the desert, doing what he's doing. So,
if the Flames go to the second round, you want to see like a Gaudreau jersey next week?
100%. I mean, like, and that's the reason why I'm chair for Leafs as well, right? I want to see Giordano on the Leafs do well. So, and then it'd be nice to see a Gaudreau.
All right. Perfect, man. Thank you. All right, joined by Cole Keith. So Cole, massive win. How are you guys kind of feeling after that game? And looking forward to obviously a big couple of weeks for you guys here.
Yeah, I mean, confidence should be high after that. I mean, we had a couple weeks there where we didn't perform to our ability, and I think we all know that. So I think following up this, leading into this Thursday's game against Boston, we should take confidence and hopefully build onto a good performance there.
Yeah, and obviously a lot of tries in this game today came a lot from the work from the forwards and stuff as well. It's like, what's been, just a lot of front row tries and things like that too. It's like, what's been working well for the pack up front? Seems to be a big driving force for the team right now.
Yeah, I mean, we work a lot on it throughout the week and stuff and try and, get some go forward and some purchase there, but it's not just the forwards, those backs create holes and they create the space, drawing players, side to side, and credit goes to them just as much as it is us. We just happen to finish them every so often, so.
Yeah, and so obviously you guys got New England in just a few days now. How different is, the prep for a game that's on a Thursday night, such a short week compared to the typical Saturdays or Sundays?
Yeah, I mean, we'll focus on our recovery tonight and tomorrow, and then The week will, yeah, be modified a bit training-wise, load-wise, but yeah, I think we just stick to, you know, what we're doing, what we know, and we'll, boys, we prepare for Thursday to go. Right. So.
Hey Ross, so first game back after after a stint on the injured list, is how are you feeling after that 40 minutes in the first half there?
I feel pretty good. I think it was good for me to get out. I think this was a perfect game for me to come back in into the systems and stuff. I think it was good for me to get back into this game. I have a feel of it. I think I came back and felt pretty good, so I can take confidence of that.
Yeah, perfect. And you obviously, you know, first in the, early in the game had a couple big line breaks and obviously scored a try for yourself. So what were you kind of seeing in the Dallas defense that kind of led to those big plays?
No, I could see the Dallas, they were here to play. A lot of energy, so they wanted to get off the line and maybe just leaving a gap open here and there, and just took on the opportunity. So yeah, they were really keen to play and just left that one or two gaps open.
And you guys obviously have a massive stretch of games coming up. First is New England on Thursday night. So, like, how do you guys going into preparing for that game on such a short turnaround? Obviously, you know, a lot of guys coming back from injury, a couple guys being rested and stuff too. So, how are you guys feeling going into the final push at the end of the year here?
I think we all realize what how serious the next couple games are. We need to win. We need to get bonus points to have a stretch in the playoffs. So New England, a much different team, and we have to build on this performance and train really hard and mentally be ready for it.
All right, perfect, Ross. Thank you for your time.
Thanks so much.